Breaking news this morning. A man was shot and killed in Clarksville overnight. Sky 5 was over that scene earlier this morning at Memorial Drive. We're told the shooting happened about 3 o'clock, so 4 hours ago. But the scene is still active right now. A suspect is in custody. The road is closed between Fairway Drive and Alfred Drive for those of you who have to get out and move about in that area. We've got a call into detectives trying to get more details. As soon as we get them, we will pass them along to you. And an SUV crashed into the West Police Precinct. That's over on Charlotte Pike. Police tell us the driver thought he was getting onto the interstate, but ended up crashing into a gate on the side road. He was not seriously hurt, but the Metro Police are charging him with DUI. We're told this is at least his third arrest for drunk driving. And happening right now, the search is on for two people wanted for shooting a man in the face. Let's get straight to Cuthbert Langley, who's at the Criminal Justice Center for us this morning. And Cuthbert, this is a really strange case. This guy actually shot in the face, but actually was able to drive to the hospital.
Amy, he was. It's a pretty remarkable story. Police say he was out of his car when two men approached him. Once he was shot, though, he was able to make his way to the hospital and not only do that, but also give police a pretty good description of who they're looking for. But the search is now entering into its 12th hour. Let's take a look at the scene from last night. This happened around 7:15. Police say the guy was driving down the road near 14th Avenue North. He was driving into a driveway when two men approached him, came up to him, and one of those guys ended up pulling out a gun and shooting the man in the face. As we've been saying, though, he was able to make his way back into the car and drive to the hospital. He was later transported to Vanderbilt Medical Center, where he was able to give police a good description of the two suspects. One was wearing a cowboy hat and a red jacket, the other wearing a black shirt. He also was able to give police a pretty good piece of information as well, that they escaped in either a black Chevy Impala or black Nissan Altima. So if you know anything that could get these two suspected shooters off the streets this morning, Crime Stoppers is your best bet. Give them a call with any tips that could get these folks arrested. And as we've been saying, good news this morning, the victim is expected to be okay. We're live at the Metro Jail this morning. I'm Cuthbert Langley, News Channel 5 HD.
Cuthbert, thank you for that update. And a 15-year-old is recovering after getting shot in the foot over the weekend in the parking lot of the Home Depot. This is the store on Powell Avenue. It happened just before 11 Saturday night. That's near 100 Oaks Mall. Detectives say witnesses gave conflicting stories, so they're still trying to piece together what happened. A 5-year-old is in the hospital this morning after getting struck by a vehicle. According to the Kentucky New Era, it happened yesterday afternoon in the St. Elmo community in Christian County. Deputies say the little girl was playing in a neighbor's driveway when she was hit. She was flown to Vanderbilt University Medical Center for back pain. However, we're told her injuries do not appear to be life-threatening, and no charges are expected to be filed in the accident. We now know the name of the man hit and killed by an SUV in North Nashville. Metro Police say Wayne Elam was walking in a crosswalk near the intersection of Garfield Street and Delta Avenue when he was hit Saturday night. The driver, Ann Allen, told officers that she didn't see the 64-year-old. We're told that it doesn't appear that alcohol or drugs were involved, but the DA's office will decide if charges will be filed. Speed, though, is being blamed for a crash that knocked the power out to thousands yesterday morning. It happened in the River Trace area just north of Briley Parkway near Madison. We're told a driver lost control on Lock 2 Road around 2:30 a.m. and slammed into a pole, splitting it in half. More than 2,000 people were without electricity for about 2 hours. The driver suffered minor injuries. No word yet if that driver will face charges. Take a look at this massive house fire in Cookeville. Pictures of the scene sent to us from East First Street, close to Dogwood Park. We're told smoke from that fire yesterday afternoon could be seen for several blocks. The home suffered damage, but no one was hurt, rather. No word yet on what started the fire. Police are going to need your help getting back some priceless silver items that were taken from a church in Thompson Station. So take a look and see if you can recognize the thief in this surveillance photo. It's a pretty clear photo. The Thompson Station Church of Christ, it happened around there 8:45 Friday night, and they tell us he was about there for about an hour, and he took silver items like communion trays and a pitcher dating back to the 19th century. If you can help identify this man, call Williamson County Crime Stoppers at 615-794-4000. A local food ministry is trying to figure out who broke into their building Saturday night and trashed the place. Folks who run the Journey of Hope Food Ministry near Bell Buckle say the damage is worth thousands of dollars. In addition to all sorts of food being opened and left on the floor, several refrigerators were smashed and broken, and they say it could have fed 24 families. What was lost? Amid all that waste, though, there may be something valuable the vandals left behind.
The flour is what's going to catch these guys because they got their footprints. They know what size shoes they wear.
Well, they hope to have the food ministry back up and running by this Friday. And a bill that could make flying drones over stadiums illegal is set to be passed today in the State House and the Senate. This viral video is said to be the inspiration for the original bill. The bill's sponsors say the Titans wanted to know if there were any laws to protect crowds from drone flights after the team's management saw this video of Nashville's 4th of July fireworks show. The House version of the bill says people cannot fly drones over any outdoor venue where there are more than 100 people at a ticketed event without permission. The Senate version goes a step farther and would ban drones over any designated fireworks display site without permission. Opening day at the Nashville Sounds' new downtown ballpark is less than 3 weeks away, but neighbors, all they can think about right now is where is everybody going to park? Earlier this month, project leaders announced that the parking garage for the First Tennessee Park wouldn't be finished until the fall. So they've since put together a contingency plan, but neighbors are worried that not everyone will follow the rules. They're getting together with reps from the Sounds organization and Metro Councilwoman Erica Gilmore tonight at the Skillery. That meeting begins at 6:30. Opening day at First Tennessee Park is Friday, April 17th.